How many times have you heard that a building needs to breathe? But what does breathability actually mean? Okay, this is going to get really confusing. Joseph, what is the definition of breathability?
Well, breathability and breathe is a very confusing term because the everyday used term is meaning how we inhale and exhale of air. In the material science term, breathability is about how well a material can allow moisture and water vapor to permeate through in order to maintain a balance of vapor or moisture level on both sides of the material.
So, Andy, on this product you've got Let Your Building Breathe. What does that mean for the wall cavity in relation to air tightness?
To a certain extent, we are guilty of using a bit of marketing, which really confuses on the building science side of things.
Yeah.
So people need to breathe. It's a physical action of breathing, inhaling and exhaling, just like you said. Mm-hmm. But we're wrapping up a building here with an airtight material.
Right.
So there's no air movement moving from side to side of this material.
Yep.
But what it does is that it allows vapor to pass through this material, so you're not getting condensation forming on the inside of that material by allowing vapor to pass through. Perhaps we need to change the logo.
So this keeps your wall cavity dry and then also allows your insulation to work as it's been designed.
So you've got essentially a water control layer. So during construction and for the life of the building, this is a water control layer to stop liquid water from getting into the building. Yep. The other side of water is that when water is a gas and reaches a dew point, it turns into water, and you don't want that to happen within your insulation. You don't want to have that happen on the structural side of your building wrap. Mm-hmm. So you need to get that vapor to pass through slowly. Mm-hmm. Into the cavity, yeah, where it can drain away, yeah, safely.
So Andy, this product is fantastic for keeping water out of the wall system. How do other products compare to this product?
So there are a lot of different technologies about providing breathability within textiles. Mm-hmm. Now this works because there's a micropore film there, mm-hmm, which based on vapor pressure difference allows vapor to pass through very small pores within the material. Mm-hmm. It still maintains under normal circumstances a very good airtight layer. Yeah. The other technologies which we also use are air permeable membranes, which have a certain degree of water holdout, but they transport that vapor through them through air movement. So you can have excellent levels of vapor permeability, but there is some sacrifice in terms of both airtightness and water tightness.
So Andy, what criteria does the EnviroSeal ProctorWrap product cover for building performance?
Okay, so when we talked about earlier about the building envelope, yep, and materials acting as control layers, mm-hmm, we look at what control layer functions the membrane can offer.
Yep.
So primarily you've got your temporary and your long-term water control layer to stop water getting in.
Yep.
But also because of the nature of the product, it also provides an air control layer. Yep. If we're buying an airtight material, you're not having air movement through the wrap, yeah, provided it's adequately taped and formed a complete air barrier.
Yeah.
The other function it does is it ensures by being vapor permeable, allows the vapor to escape through the membrane safely without causing damage within the structure and within the insulation.
Okay. So in a nutshell, the EnviroSeal ProctorWrap is a multi-function product, not a single function product.
So to finish with this, modern-day building products and airtight construction can be breathable, which means it can diffuse moisture trapped in the wall construction without moving air through. Watch our follow-up video on building performance, where we go over the super exciting concepts of control layers for maintaining a healthy and higher performing building.